going to ask if everyone can mute themselves. I'm Sharonica Hart-Bartley, I serve as superintendent, and so we're excited to host the Parent Cafe, a day in the life of preschool. One of the things I say about our preschool program, whenever I'm having a tough day or I just need a pick-me-up or I want to feel some joy, you just walk into Julia Goldstein and it just makes all your problems go away. It's truly an amazing place for young people, and Ms. Colley and her team do a wonderful, wonderful job. So this is really her presentation. I just wanted to say welcome, and I know your children will be well cared for, and we just hope that very, very soon we can get them back to in-person. So I'll turn it over to Ms. Colley. Thank you for joining us. The format for today is we will go through a presentation, and then we have a small group today, so you really don't have to use the chat function, but you can if you're more comfortable with that, or you can just ask us questions once she concludes, and we'll be able to respond to, well, she'll be responding to most of the questions, but if there's any district-related questions, I'll be happy to respond. So, Ms. Colley.
Well, good morning. My name is Crystal Colley. I'm the principal of Julia Goldstein Early Childhood, as Dr. Harden just said. This is my 11th year as building leader. I'm excited to tell you all about Julia Goldstein and how we will begin the 2020-21 school year. This is a parent cafe, so you will have a time at the end to converse. I will be happy to answer any questions that you have. I wanted to start with this slide. I actually borrowed it from Dr. Harden's, one of her presentations, and I'm starting with this slide because it's the why of Julia Goldstein. It reflects our why. And when I say that, it's why we do the work that we do. So if you're looking at a picture of kindergartners at Jackson Park, and of the 14 kindergartners pictured here, 12 of those students came from Julia Goldstein. And that says a lot. That says a lot about our work at Julia Goldstein. It says a lot about our families. Our families are choosing U City. They're choosing to stay. And we're so proud of that. And also, if you look at the picture, you see a lot. You see happy children. You see children who are smiling and have a bright light. And that bright light means that they're ready to go on and learn great things. And we believe that that started not only first at home with our families, but then we were able to carry that on at Julia Goldstein. So it's very exciting. The well-being of the children that we educate is our top priority. It's one of our strategic priorities as a district and as an early childhood program. Julia Goldstein is a safe place with a caring staff, and we're committed to working with our families to ensure that all of our students are provided with a quality learning experience. This was our mission before the pandemic and will continue to be our mission as we go forward in our future. We are preparing our children to be both in person and virtual, and we're prepared to handle that. So what you see here is the back to school plan. It was our greatest desire, as Dr. Harden has mentioned in many of her calls, it was our greatest desire to begin with our students full time in person every day. Having to pivot our decision due to the number of COVID cases in our region, we are starting with the distance learning plan. So we're starting all distance right now. With this distance learning model, our students are assigned to a classroom teacher with a group of students that they will get to know while virtual. Once we are in the building for the Brick Academy blended model, students will attend in person for 2 days in the building and 3 virtual days at home. So what you see here now is the blended model, and you'll see that our children will be at the pre-K in 2 cohorts. Classrooms of 9 students for 2 full days back to back, and then the other 3 days will be virtual. The students will be learning virtual at home, and we'll use that same schedule when we're in the blended version at school. When we pivot to in-person learning, the health and well-being of our students is our top priority. To keep our students safe, it will take a collaborative effort between our staff and you, the families. We need you to complete a morning health screener every day before school, and that will give us information to move forward with. Our day starts at 8:30 for a full day and ends at 3:30. To meet the needs of our students and their families, we have a blend of synchronous and asynchronous learning opportunities. Synchronous learning is real-time learning and allows our children to learn together on the same platform. Some students are able to receive or will receive immediate feedback and attention from teachers. Actually, all students will do that. Asynchronous learning means that our families will be able to access the lessons that we teach, but in a recorded format. So this gives you some flexibility at home if you're not able to attend live sessions. And it also allows children to engage with you while the learning is going on. Our schedule is similar to the elementary, but it takes into consideration the developmental level of our students who range from 3 to 5 years of age. As you look at the schedule, and you'll get a chance to see it more closely because it's actually posted on the website, and also you'll receive a copy from the teacher. You'll be able to see when lessons are scheduled. But the morning consists of live and asynchronous learning from 9 to 11, and then your afternoon is pretty open and flexible, but it allows you to make appointments with your child's teacher. There are breaks and rest times built into the schedule, and you'll see that too. But we're also focusing on literacy and math in the morning, so you'll have that option of having individual support for that in the afternoon as well. At Julia Goldstein, Learning Reimagined is the way young children learn in our district. We are a Reggio-inspired preschool implementing project-based learning. Our teachers provoke learning experiences and opportunities that allow our children to express how capable they are and to explore their inquiries in literacy, science, and math. Each year, we engage our families in a building-wide question, a building-wide focus as an entire school community. This allows us to engage with our families, hear their voices and their ideas about what their children are learning and the experiences that they have at home. We plan to honor our children's voices just as we have in the past. And you'll see that in a project-based learning opportunity we have. We're constructing an all-school book club, and it's ongoing. And then we'll also have STEAM opportunities that we engage your children in. This, I know the questions that I just, or the information that I just shared with you doesn't touch on all the things that you want to know about. So this isn't a time for you now to ask any questions that you have, and feel free to also reach out to me later and I'll answer those questions personally. Our leadership has been thinking long and hard about how we will reenter. We're prepared. We're prepared for both virtual and we're prepared for the blended model when we're back in the building. And we look forward to that opportunity. I'll open it up for any questions that you have right now.
Hi, this is Stacey Jones, Chase Jones' mother. So I understand Friday will start at 9 a.m. to 11.
I'm sorry, it's breaking up a little bit. I wasn't able to hear that. Someone else hear it?
The schedule, is it 9 a.m. to 11? Is that your question? Was that your question? You're on mute.
Okay, my question was the virtual school, it would start at 9 a.m. to 11, will be live sessions, and you'll do a pre-recording, is that what?
So there will be a mix of live, so asynchronous and synchronous, there will be a mix of both. So there will be a recorded session, but we're gonna start our day with a community meeting, which is live. And then it'll be followed up with the other subjects. Like we'll have studio creative arts. Those will be recorded sessions. And then we'll have time for math and literacy, which might start with the recorded session, but then teachers will break out into small groups with students so that it could be live interaction.
Okay.
So it'll be a mix of both because we do understand the needs of our families and also the attention span of our students to be able to attend to long periods of time where it's all live won't work for this age level. So we're going to make sure that we have both.
And will it be 5 days a week?
So we're going to have 5 days of learning virtually. When we're in session, that's when I was speaking of the 2-day model where you'll be in this building 2 days and then 3 virtual days. But as we are virtual, all virtual in the distance learning plan, there will be actually 4 days of learning. 1 day is a pre-recorded day, that's your Wednesday, but it's still a day of learning. You'll just have access to the pre-recorded lessons and it'll give you time to catch up.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Are there any other questions? Or maybe I sparked one based on...
Could you go back to the screen that has the schedule, the sort of the more specific schedule? Yeah, that one.
Mm-hmm.
Is that available somewhere other than this presentation?
Yes, it's on the district website, posted in the roadmap to learning. Then also it will be on our page, the website for Julia Goldstein. And then your classroom teacher will provide you with a copy. So this is a pretty general schedule, but it is the one we will follow. There will be some specifics of the day that the teachers will share with you. Also, it will get more specific once we're in person in the Brick Academy.
So are the students expected to be in front of the computer then the whole time from 9 to 11?
So we're offering opportunities for that. So from 9 to 9:25, that's a classroom meeting. That's when they're actually meeting with their classroom teacher and then engage with their peers. But the other opportunities, like I said, it'll start with a possible live lesson here. For instance, say literacy, there might be a read aloud that's recorded, but then they would break up into groups with the teachers who are on that team, and then they would have some interaction there. So again, these lessons will have a recorded component, and so that if that's too much for your child, you can access it here on Wednesday, and then or Thursday and Friday, or any other time, maybe evening, where you want to work with your child more closely and there you feel like they're ready and can attend. This also at this time here, 1:40 to 3:30 actually, is when your children would have the time to review those lessons and or differentiate the lessons for your child. You will have access to your child's teacher, so you can set up an appointment with them and then you can have some one-on-one learning during this time too. But that will be a schedule that you set up with the individual classroom teacher. So there again, there's a balance of recorded and live because we do understand the attention span of students to be able to attend that long, but we also understand that our families can't all access what we're doing at the time we're giving it. And so it's an opportunity to do that at another point.
So is Wednesday a day to basically catch up on stuff that the kids did not get to on the other 4 days, or does Wednesday have new material that's presented in a recorded fashion?
So the music is just an additional offering and something for you to access to give your child that experience. But no, it is also a day, yes, it is a day for you to play catch up. If you were not able to access all of these lessons on that day, you would be able to review them on Wednesday. Or if you just want to review them again on Wednesday, you can do that. There is no direct contact between students and teachers. You may receive a check-in, or you can check in, attempt to check in with the teacher. But this is a day of learning for us as a district. So teachers will be in professional development. They will be in collaborative meetings, planning for the next week, and all of that. But yes, Wednesday is the day for you to decide how you want to address the learning. And then Thursday and Friday are days that are similar to Monday and Tuesday, but with the focus on our project-based learning, which is the book club that I mentioned that's ongoing, and it's going to engage all families. It was designed with the idea that we would have families be a big part of that. And then STEAM learning, so that would be a lesson where provided by our studio teacher, that's going to be recorded, and so it's something that you could also do when you're able. But these are the time frames we're providing to provide structure for those families who really wanted that. There's a balance, those who want a loose schedule, and then there are going to be those who want a structured schedule such as this one, and it is in alignment to the elementary schedule.
I'm sorry, I don't think I have my phone on mute. That was Chase okay. Talking to me.
Okay, hi, Chase.
I apologize.
Are there any other questions? You will get the schedule and you will see it. It's in the district roadmap and posted there with all the other grade level schedules. And then you will have a chance to go over it with your teacher. Currently, they're working on it, planning for the activities and lessons that we're talking about here. So the first week or so, it's going to be a lot of getting to know the children and getting children acclimated to learning in the way that we're delivering it, and that's the virtual platform right now. So, but the schedule, as children develop a routine and learn the routine, will become even more solid for it. Are there any
other questions? I got a question. I don't know if anybody can hear me. Sorry, I'm at work and I got to wear this mask. But so I see that it said that it's going to be till October. So what's going to happen after October?
So first quarter ends October 23rd. So we're virtual until then. The decision will be made by the superintendent, and she may speak to that now. But the decision to, the decision how we enter, if we enter it blended or if we remain, that will be made as a district. Considering, Dr. Harden, if you want to add to that.
I think you covered it. So we'll be evaluating the current metrics that we're looking at as a county. Our goal is to have consistency across the area districts, so that we're using similar metrics such as positivity rate, transmission rate, and then of course the number of cases. Our positivity rate in the county is hovering around 11%. And basically that means that 11% of the people who are tested are coming with a positive result. So that is concerning. So we do have some work to do as a region, as a county, to really curb the spread. So everything that you're doing at home to be safe, to socially distance, to monitor the amount of people that you're interacting with, that helps us get back to school quicker. And also we are hoping for a more rapid test so that we can get rapid results in a timely fashion in the event when we do get a case, because we're going to get it. It's inevitable. We've already had cases in our district with our administrators. Everyone's safe, but it's inevitable that it's going to happen, and it's just a matter of what procedures do we have in place to minimize any exposure and again to keep students and adults safe.
But either way, we will be prepared as a staff. Like I said, our leadership team and our staff, we've been discussing re-entry and what that would look like since the spring, and so we've looked at every particular area, started to brainstorm about the way we're going to enter, so we will be prepared.
Chris, did you want to speak to the devices that the students are going to get?
So each student will receive a device. They're getting Samsung tablets, and those tablets are compatible with the platform that we're using. Currently, we're using the Google platform, just like the elementary, middle, and high school, and we're holding Zoom meetings just like the other grade levels, so you'll be able to do that using the Samsung tablet. It hasn't arrived yet, but when you do, we will make sure you notify and you'll get those out to you. This week, actually Thursday, we have a distribution. We're actually giving supplies out to all of the families. So you should be hearing from your teacher more about that. And also we sent out a flyer to all of our families who we have emails for. But it's a superhero day. Superheroes wear masks at JG. So we're hoping that you come by so we can celebrate your children. We're very excited about having them. So we're gonna pass out some materials to you to get us started for our school year.
Okay, this is Stacy Jones again. When you guys resume school October 16th, will the children be required to wear a mask?
So right now, no, early childhood will have to, children will have to wear masks. The teachers will, though. We will be covered up and protecting your children. So that's an option, though. We did have a couple of parents who asked, could their children wear masks? They actually like doing that. And of course, that's an option that you have.
Okay. I was just saying because my son has like a little case of asthma, so we don't put him on the mask, but at the school that he goes to now, the teachers, they wear masks and gloves.
It's not required for our students, but it is required for our staff and teachers.
And what will we know who are our children's teachers?
So right now, you should be starting to hear from your teacher, the classroom teacher that is assigned to your child. If you have not, you can always call our office. Barbara, our secretary, will give you that information, but you will also receive another written letter. I've written letters in the last couple of weeks, just letting you know what's coming up, but I will also send a letter confirming your child's teacher. So you should be receiving that, but you can always call us at the office and Barbara will give you that information.
Let's call.
Okay, one more question. Sorry, guys.
Oh, I appreciate it.
When you guys start back school October 16th, will you guys have before and after school care with the YMCA?
So yes, we do have the YMCA, and they we are still in negotiations, discussions with them about what that care will look like. We're considering an opportunity for the Wednesday. That's not settled yet, but yes, the YMCA will provide before and after care. But we will have to have cohorts, and so that's more information that we'll share with you later too, because we want to be able to contract trace if we need to. So there will be a strict structure for that, and I can share that with you at a later date.
Okay, thank you.
Sure. There are no other questions, but do feel free to email me. My email is at the end of the PowerPoint presentation, but also it's available to you through the district website. I look forward to speaking with any of you at any time, answering any questions. You can call me as well.
I actually do. I have another question about class sizes. Mm-hmm. What will the class size be when they're back in person?
So if we were, when we come back in the blended model, there will be 9 children per classroom per cohort. So if you are in cohort A, which is the first 2 days, then your child will be in a classroom with 8 other students, 9 total, and then 2 teachers, 1 classroom teacher and 1 instructional aide. If we were to, when we make it back to the full person, you know, everyone in session, a classroom is 18. So it's 18 and 2 teachers.
Okay. But while we are will my preschooler be in the same family cohort as my elementary kids, so they would be on the same day?
Yes, so the students are assigned a family ID number, and that helps us to keep track. So yes, the family cohort will be honored.
And Laura, you should have your cohort for the elementary student. Okay, and
my preschooler's not registered yet.
He'll be in the same cohort.
Okay.
Yes, our goal is to make it flexible for you and make it work for each family and to maintain safety. So that is a priority. Were there any questions anywhere in the chat or Q&A form, Carol Ann?
There are no questions in the chat, just a lot of thank yous.
Thank you. I thank you for attending. I look forward to working with each and every family. Our staff does too. We're preparing right now. I'm very excited about your learners coming to Julia Goldstein. Thank you. Thank you for the opportunity to share.
Thank you very much. Have a good day.
You
too.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We look forward to
it.
Bye.
Thank you. Have a good day.
You too.
Thanks.